Yes.
All right. What we are going to do is, once we get them all squared away outside, the leadership students from fourth period are going to come in here. We are going to create a tunnel for them, the leadership students. We are at the same time, we'll indicate, we'll tell you when to do it. We're going to ask all of you to stand as they come in, and let's give them a big round of applause. All right? Easy to do? All right. Couple of housekeeping items. They'll touch base with the students again. At the conclusion of the ceremony, you are more than welcome to check your student now. Good luck with that. They're 4.0 students. They don't like getting checked out. But if you can get them out, more power to you. Have a great lunch. You're more than welcome to do it. We do ask, the sign-up sheets are going to be over there. You can just write your student's name and then sign it. And we will turn those into attendance, letting them know that you are taking your student. All right, we're excited. You're not gonna, I used to give a little speed. I'm done, I'm not talking anymore. We're gonna turn this over. This is a 100% student-driven production. The leadership students here at Great Oak High School, there is an entire committee that is devoted to this, and they have been working on it. They're any of my committee members, Mariah Arden. So, Craig. Anyways, they are. There's about seven of them, and they have put together this entire production. You're probably, some of you are sitting there too going, oh, how long is this going to take? I have had, I did have someone that said, I am taking off work, this better be a long time. And I said, oh, no. I go, nobody wants to sit there for, I'm a firm believer award ceremonies should be short and sweet. Our goal will be no more than 30 minutes from beginning to end. It's going to be an awesome event. It's going to be cool seeing your kid come up. You're more than welcome to come out of your seat. It is alphabetical, so you should know when your student is coming up. But I believe in short and sweet. And at the same time, lunch is coming up. We got to get the kids back to class. Can't keep them out another period. They're only cleared right now for fourth, unless you check them out. So, all right. So we will get started here shortly. Enjoy the music. Once we get all the kids, we've confirmed that the teachers have cleared them, we will get started. So again, congratulations. A huge accomplishment. I will share this. You're not going to get a whole lot of information from when the students start the ceremony. We used to keep it at a very narrow amount, a very limited amount of students that got the academic letter. What we found is our old criteria used to be they had to have six semesters of 4.0. What we found is that we were leaving out a large chunk of amazing students. So what we did is we went ahead and we expanded it. What we have found is right at about the 175 mark, there's 175 students who have a 4.0 plus here at this school. That's remarkable when you stop and think that we have 800 students here at Great Oak High School. And you have that many students who are 4.0 plus students. So we found that right at about the 175 mark is a clean cut. I think we're actually at 176 because there was a tie right at the end. But nobody knows who that 176 student is. And nobody knows who number one is. We treat them all equally today. That's right. So again, congratulations. We are excited that you made it. Chair-wise, I apologize if we don't have any more chairs. We utilized every chair we got. There are some. Yeah, we've got a chair right here if anybody wants it. You got an empty chair, you know, raise your hand. Try to help people find seats. But again, it won't be a super long ceremony, so standing isn't going to be too painful. All right, so at this point, we're going to start clearing those students, making sure they're here. And oh, there's Ashley. Ashley's another one of the commissioners in charge of this. And we'll get going here in a few minutes. Thank you.
Thank you. But my face all functions.
Thank you.
what, 4 years?
No, she's a contact lens, dude. Look, she's a contact lens. I think so.
This is high enough. I won't block you.
I don't know.
I don't think so. You come well prepared. Very well prepared.
You're welcome to that. You have to be the same.
All right, nurse, listen very carefully. Is your student, let me know, Autumn Denine. Are you in here,
yeah.
Parents of Autumn?
She's at home.
All right.
She's at home.
Okay, thank you. Maddie Clayton.
Not here.
All right, how about David Kiba? All right. Jeremiah Jones? Out of town. Cole Yeager. All right. He's the one we don't have yet. Madeline Young. Okay. I can't read if they checked it or not. So we verify that. And we're going to find out where Cole is, and we're going to get started.
Thank you.
our top 175 students. So.
It's a little more impressive, I think, than the average high school of 3,000 kids. I'm incredibly honored and impressed by the work of these seniors. And I know that second semester, especially the last couple months, there'll be more accolades, and many of you will have earned those with AP Scholars and all of that other fun stuff, scholarships. But this is really the first big thank you. I know that we like to highlight of the first semester, and I think it fills the tank up just a little bit to drag you through some of those senioritis days, which will come. It's a real thing. We hope you get mostly through spring break and back before we have to drag you across the finish line. But I think at this point, it would only be appropriate to thank all of those who have helped you and supported you along the way. So let's give a round of applause to all those teachers, parents, grandparents, other family members are the ones that when you had the light on at 1 o'clock in the morning have come down the hallway and said, hey, that's enough, that it's time to get some rest. Or they're the ones who've been driving you from point A to point B or practice five in a week, and that you're going to grow up and probably have to do someday. And so that cycle kind of comes full circle. With kids who are deeply committed, academically inquisitive, lifelong learners, but also competitive and driven and goal-oriented. And that's this group right here. If you were any less than that, you wouldn't be sitting among this group of 175 students. And as you think about that, this isn't gonna be the end of your academic journey. Certainly you have second semester, many of you have tests that you're gonna be sitting for, exams that you've kind of worked 4 years to see how you can do. Not yet, you have time. But really that's the culmination of all that content, knowledge, and curriculum that you've kind of accessed and been poured into. And so that part's exciting, but it's also stressful. It's also, motivating when you think about the next chapter in the next couple months. You'll be hearing about college acceptances, and those are always the things that we love celebrating with our students who've worked so hard. Everyone's applied and they're waiting, and that's, some days stressful and anxiety is part of that. Wherever you get accepted is where you're supposed to be, because your college experience is gonna be exactly what you make of it. And so we're excited to hear that news in the coming months. But also there's gonna be more challenges in front of you. There's gonna be more sleepless nights, more successes, and there's gonna be a little failure because that's an important part of life. And some of you haven't experienced very much of that. We have students sitting here that have only ever earned an A in anything that they've accessed their entire life. And that's straight impressive, but also probably not reality. As you go on to access higher level education. And some of you are gonna work on an undergraduate degree, a postgraduate degree. Some of you are gonna be like our assistant principal, Dr. Lane, who earns a PhD. I mean, all of that comes with a deep committedness to what you're doing, but it might not be perfect. It might not be the straight A. And so enjoy this process, but also know that all the critical thinking that you've done, all the time management and balancing that's come with you getting yourself to this particular place today, those are all skills, life skills, that are gonna come back into effect as you continue to push yourself in higher education. And we're super proud of that commitment, and the scholarship heart of spirit is very much what we honor probably most some days at Great Oak High School and pride ourselves on. And it's really the legacy of students like this 175 who continue to keep that S very strong in spirit. And so we just want to celebrate you today. I thought that was a fun entrance. I know it's like you guys are all sitting here giving my certificate, move on. But we just want to tell you congratulations. I know it hasn't been easy, but certainly this is a little bit of that pat on the back today. You're gonna get a certificate. Their certificate basically will help you get the letter, and they'll give you some more details about that after the event. So on behalf of Great Oak High School, our teaching staff, our support staff, and our administration, we couldn't be more proud of all the work that you've done So thank you for that commitment to academic rigor. We're super proud of you.
Thank you.
us, we all highly cherish your academic contributions to Great Oaks. So with one last, can we give them a huge round of applause?